Good morning, students. In the previous class, we discussed about the judiciary system which is available for the grievance handling in case of violation of human rights. Today, we will discuss about another mechanism which has been framed by government and which is known as National Human Rights Commission, that is NHRC, which is an apex body, we can say that who deals with the redressal of various kinds of violations of human rights. So, NHRC was constituted in October 1993 and it is a complete autonomous body. It means its function is completely independent. Composition is like there is a chairperson. Chairperson should be one who has been a Chief Justice of Supreme Court. Then there is a Secretary General. Secretary General is one who is of rank Secretary to the Government of India. And then there are other members. In members, there is one who is at least a judge of Supreme Court who is or has been. Then another one is Chief Justice of High Court who is or has been a Chief Justice, right? Then two members to be appointed from people who are having knowledge or practical experience about human rights or matters or complaints or issues related to human rights. And then chairperson of National Commission for Minorities, National Commission for Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe, National Commission for Women. All these chairpersons are also member of this NHRC. So these commissions we are going to discuss in next video. Then other staff members include one officer who is not below the rank of DGP, that is Director General of Police. Then certain investigative staff because they have to investigate about the complaints, other administrative, technical and scientific staff as the requirement is. So this is the composition of NHRC. Now how these are appointed? The appointments are made by President on the recommendation of committee which consists of following members. The chairperson of this committee is Prime Minister. Then the members of this committee are Speaker of the House of the People, Minister in charge of MHA in Government of India, MHA is Ministry of Human Affairs, then Leader of the Opposition in the House of People, then Leader of the Opposition in the Council of State and Deputy Chairman of the Councils of State. So these people are the members of the Recruitment or Recommendation Committee who appoints the members of NHRC. Then the headquarters of NHRC is in Delhi. Branch offices are in different places in India, but those branches are opened with the prior approval of central government. Now the tenure or the term of the members, chairperson and members tenure is 5 years from the date of assumption of the office or until the age of 70, whichever is earlier. If a person reaches the age of 70 only after 3 years of the tenure, then also that tenure will be of 3 years only. It will not be extended beyond 70 years of age. On completion of tenure, the chairperson and members are ineligible for further appointment. It means there would not be further extension or reappointment of the same people on the same positions. Then the chairperson or members can only be removed from their office by an order of the president on ground of proved misbehavior. If anybody wants to remove the chairperson or the members of NHRC, so in that case the order from the president is required, and that also there should be a proven ground of misbehavior or incapacity, that is they are not capable of, after the Supreme Court has recommended such removal after inquiry. So it is not an easy process. First Supreme Court will decide whether this allegation or whether this complaint is genuine or not, and if Supreme Court feels so, after the inquiry they will produce an order or recommendation, and finally that will be approved by the president. Only then the chairperson of or member of NHRC can be removed before completion of their tenure. Now what are the functions of NHRC? There are various functions of these kind of commissions. The first function is to inquire about the violation of human rights in the country. Then negligence in prevention of such violation by the public servant, because it is the duty of government to protect people, to make sure that everybody gets their rights, to make sure nobody violate their rights. So in this scenario, they will also find out because of whose negligence those rights have been violated. Then second is intervention. The NHRC has the right or the function of intervention wherever the violation of rights have been found. Then visit. For this purpose, to collect the data, to inquire, to ask questions, they will visit various places, various offices. Then review. They generally keep on reviewing the various policies, laws, rules and regulation, rights, international scenario about human rights and everything, so that recommendations could be made. So these reviews are about safeguard provided by the constitution or any law, and give recommendation for their effective implementation, that how further steps could be taken to ensure effective implementation of these rights. Then factors that inhibit the enjoyment of human rights and recommendation recommend appropriate remedial measure, that what are the factors which are responsible for non-enjoyment of human rights and how further remedial steps can be taken to make this sure that the people enjoy their human rights. Then the treaties and other international instruments on human rights, whatever has been signed at the international level, whatever has been implemented at the international level, they review those treaties and instruments and give their recommendation about the effective implementation of those measures. Then they conduct research on regular basis about various areas, means what are the factors which are responsible for violation, in which areas violations are more, or what could be done to improve the situation. All kind of research is done by them. Then another function is awareness building. They try to make various efforts or steps to increase the awareness about human rights among the masses. For that, they publish different kind of information, or they make short films, or they launch certain awareness campaigns also. These are various kinds of activities which they do under this. Then finally, support. The commission support and encourages the efforts of various NGOs and institutions working for protection of human rights. Now, what are their powers? They could exercise all powers of a civil court, trying a suit under the Code of Civil Procedure 1908 in respect of following. So they have all the powers which a civil court has, and they can conduct a suit or a case under the Code of Civil Procedure 1908 in the following situations. First is in enforcing attendance of witnesses and examining them on oath. Whomsoever are the witness, they can enforce them to attend the case, and they will examine them after giving them the oath. Then discovery and production of any document. They can find out, they can ask for any kind of document from any kind of office. Receiving evidence on affidavit. They can ask for affidavits from different people in form of evidences. Then requisitioning any public record or copy from court or office. If they want anything in written form from the court or from office, they can ask for it. Then issuing commission for the examination of witness or document. They can also issue certain instruction to examine the witnesses or the documents presented by them. Any other matter which may be prescribed by the government. Now, how they deal with the complaints? First, we'll discuss the nature of complaint and how the complaint can be filed. Complaint may be in Hindi, English, or any of the regional language which has been mentioned in 8th schedule of the constitution. There will be no fee charged for any kind of complaint. That is, NHRC has the duty to deal with the complaints without any charges. Then commission may ask for further information or affidavits to support the allegation when required. If they want any kind of information or affidavit from any of the person, they can ask for it. Complaint can be accepted through telegraph or fax. It will be acceptable in any of the form. But certain kinds of complaint will not be entertained, which are like, number one, for act which happened more than 1 year before making of the complaint. If the act has taken place 1 year before before the complaint, the date on which the complaint has been made, so that complaint will not be entertained. Then for matters which are under judicial consideration, which are already in court, so those matters will not be taken up. Matters which are vague, which are not well defined, anonymous, which are without any name or pseudonym, if the false name is there, then also that complaint will not be entertained. Matter which are of frivolous, non-serious purpose will not be entertained. And then matter which are outside the purview of commission, they will not be taken care, and the service matters. So these are the kind of complaints which will not be entertained by NHRC. Then procedure of handling complaint. First step in conducting inquiry for complaint is that they may call for information from the government, central or state government, or any other authority from where they want the information. If report is received on time, commission analyze it and conclude, right? Either the concerned authority has taken required action, so no further inquiry is required. So after analysis, the following probabilities or following course of action could be taken. First course of action, if they think the concerned authority has taken the required step, so further inquiry is not required and they will stop it there. Second possibility could be, or no step has been taken till now, so there is a need to take action as no action has been taken by the concerned authority. And the third one is, if report is not submitted on time, in that case they will themselves proceed to inquire about the complaint. Then the second step is where inquiry reveal the violation of human right. It may recommend concerned authority to initiate proceeding for prosecution or any other action as commission may think appropriate against concerned person. If the inquiry tells that there is actually a violation and there are the people who are responsible for that, they can ask the concerned authority to take initial proceedings against that person who has done so. They can approach Supreme Court or High Court for such direction if they think that the authorities will not take the order seriously. So they can go via Supreme or High Court, because the written orders or instructions given by the court will be followed. They can recommend the concerned authority for grant of immediate interim relief to the victim. In certain situations, certain relief could be required by the victim also, so or to the members of the family. So in that case, they will ask the authority to provide the interim relief to the victim. Then they shall send a copy of inquiry report and recommendation to the concerned authority. After doing the complete inquiry, a report and recommendations has to be sent to the concerned authority. Then the authority will forward its comment on the report within a period of 1 month. They must also propose the action to be taken to the commission. They will, the concerned authority will tell the commission about the proposed action which they are planning to do to solve the issue. They should provide a copy of inquiry report to the petitioner also. Petitioner who has filed the complaint. So they'll provide a copy of inquiry report to the complainant also. Then finally, they shall publish this inquiry report and comments of the concerned authority and the action taken or proposed by them. So in the final annual report, which is published by NHRC, they always print all the solved cases. And in that, proper inquiry report has been published, in which the comments by the concerned authority or the action taken by the concerned authority are also mentioned. So this is the procedure, how the complaints are handled. The annual and special reports, which I just talked about, annual reports, the commission is required to submit an annual report to the central and concerned state governments about their functioning, right? Other than this, commission may submit special reports also. Annual reports are once in a year. Special reports can be published any time throughout the year. These are specially on the matters which is of such importance that it should not be deferred till submission of annual report. It means if there are certain important issues in between, it is so important to get the public to know about those important issues, and it is not appropriate to delay it till the publication of annual report. So in that scenario, special reports are published within the year also. Then finally, the central and state government shall lay these annual and special reports along with the memorandum of action taken or proposed before House of Parliament and state legislatures respectively. These annual and special reports are taken in front of House of Parliament and at the state legislatures also to tell them about the progress which NHRC has done, which actions were proposed or which actions have actually been taken for the remedy or for the redressal of the complaints to NHRC. So this is how annual and special reports are dealt with. State Human Rights Commission will discuss in the next video. Along with that, we'll discuss about various other commissions made for the separate special groups. That's all for today. Have a good day.